Orange County Department of Ed in Long Beach. It was exquisite in every way. Thank you. The conference stressed social justice and equity. However, for a State Department that emphasizes justice and equity, why would they refuse equitable access for all non-English speakers in the state by not providing the framework in their language? Isn't this hypocritical? And when many Orange County Hispanics and Asians brought this to the attention of you, Dr. Mijares, your response was silence, not advocacy. Is this the way our leaders exemplify justice and equity? On top of that, the decision to implement the framework through OCDE was made without board knowledge and without board vote. Elected board members were denied the opportunity to represent their constituents in this decision because their authority was disregarded and usurped, apparently by the superintendent. Is this how leadership exemplifies justice and equity? The OCDE and the CDE stress that the framework is an optional suggestion. However, when AB 493 soon passes, professional development of these same overlapping subjects may become mandatory. Is this an example of ethical transparency? Dr. Mijares, all teachers I know want safe, welcoming school climates for their students. However, the framework you are enthusiastically implementing recommends sex ed and HIV prevention be taught to kindergarten through third grade. It tells students they can be both genders or neither gender. That teachers should use gender-neutral pronouns such as they, them, and theirs. It says seventh graders should be taught non-monogamous, multiple romantic partners, that it's safe and inclusive. There were books recommended in the framework before the parents stormed Sacramento with opposition, recommending a school-wide read, grades 9 through 12, instructing them on bondage, sadomasochism, fisting, restraint, blood play. Is this what you consider inclusive and good for kids, Dr. Mijares? You accused Dr. Williams and the Orange County Register for misleading the public on health policies. Yet Dr. Williams created an open public forum for academic discussion to bring light on the issue. He responded to his constituents with action. The public response was so great that people had to sit outside with loudspeakers. Thank you, Dr. Williams, for your hard work to make that happen. He did not mislead. He tried to inform in a fair way with respect. Varied viewpoints were invited, but not everyone accepted the invitation. No, misleading is when someone hears thousands of constituents' grievances, both vocal and written, and in spite of this, unilaterally enters into a $5 million contract to implement the very document he said was optional. Obviously, these parents wasted their time and breath. They did not know their elected county superintendent had already made a deal with the state in February of 2018 to roll out the framework. This, Dr. Mijares, is misleading.